Welcome to Chemical Equations, in which we will find out what the symbols in an equation represent and what does a chemical equation tell us about what is happening in a chemical reaction. There are many types of chemical equations representing many types of chemical reactions. In this video, we will look at the symbols in and meaning of two equations, first the more simple one at the top, and then the more involved one below. This is what is called a skeletal equation, meaning there is no more information other than what is reacting, everything to the left of the arrow, and those are called reactants. The skeletal equation also shows what the reaction produces, to the right of the arrow, which are called products. So what do the letters and numbers mean in the equation? The letters are symbols of elements taken from the periodic table of elements. Hydrogen is H, nitrogen is N. And so the H's and the N's in the equation tell us the elements used in the reaction, hydrogen and nitrogen. Let's add back the numbers from the original skeletal equation. These numbers are called subscripts, and the subscripts tell us how many atoms of those elements there are. The subscript 2 on the H tells us there are 2 atoms of hydrogen, and there are also 2 atoms of nitrogen. Note on the product side that nitrogen has no subscript. However, just the presence of the symbol N tells us there is one nitrogen atom, so no subscript is actually a subscript of 1, but by convention we do not show the subscript 1. Here the subscript of H is 3, so there are 3 hydrogen atoms. Atoms are extremely tiny, far too tiny to see, but we can model them here as a simple circle. And in fact, atoms do have a spherical shape, or a circle in 2 dimensions. So here we model hydrogen as a yellow circle and nitrogen as a blue circle. But we are missing the most important point about the subscripts, which is because they are written as subscripts, they tell us that those atoms are chemically bonded, that they are molecules and not individual atoms. The subscript 2 and H2 tells us the 2 hydrogen atoms are bonded, N2 tells us the 2 nitrogen atoms are bonded. On the reactant side, we see that the symbols N and H are written next to each other. Very importantly, symbols of 2 different elements written next to each other also tells us that those atoms are bonded. There is also the subscript 3 telling us bonding is occurring, and so with NH3, bonding occurs with all 4 atoms. This is the NH3, or ammonia, molecule. You may have noticed that the atoms overlap when bonded. This actually does occur with bonded atoms. The atoms physically overlap. They are tightly bonded together, and it is bonded atoms that create molecules. So the skeletal equation is symbolizing the hydrogen molecule, the nitrogen molecule, and the ammonia molecule. An important thing to understand is the difference between atoms and molecules, in part because that is what the symbols are showing us. Atoms are just single units of an element, differing by the amount of protons each element has. This is showing us 2 nitrogen atoms, and here is 1 nitrogen atom and 3 hydrogen atoms. When those atoms are bonded, they become molecules. Molecules are what we call 2 or more atoms bonded together. This reaction occurs between molecules, not individual atoms, and so it is important to understand that this is what the symbols are telling us. We now need to add more information to the equation. The skeleton equation is not quite an accurate representation of the molecules involved in the reaction. We can better represent how the reaction is occurring by adding more reactants and more products until there are the same amount of atoms on both sides of the arrow. If you think of the arrow as a dividing line, whatever atoms are on the left side in the reactants have to still be present on the right side in the products. This is the law of conservation of mass. In a chemical process, mass cannot be created or destroyed. Guess where that mass comes from? That's right, it comes from the atoms. So we cannot just lose or gain atoms during the reaction. The amount of atoms we start with on the left has to be the same as the amount of atoms we end up with on the right. I hope you can see that is not the case here. There are 2 hydrogen atoms on the left, but 3 hydrogen atoms on the right. And there are two atoms of nitrogen on the left, but only one nitrogen atom on the right. To correct this, we simply add more of each substance until the atoms all balance, meaning until there are the same amount of each atom on both sides of the equation, as follows. If we add two more hydrogen molecule reactants and one more ammonia product, there are now the same amount of reactant hydrogen atoms as there are hydrogen atoms in the product, six on each side. And the two nitrogen atoms on the reactant side are now accounted for in the products as well. You may now be asking, where do these extra molecules come from? Well, the equation is representing a reaction that occurs with enormous amounts of these molecules. So for the purposes of the equation, we just take an amount of molecules that will satisfy having the same amount of each atom on both sides of the arrow, a balanced amount of atoms. However, the atoms are in molecules, so it is a balanced amount of molecules. But these balanced amount of molecules need to be reflected in the equation. And this is done by adding numbers to the equation called coefficients. For three hydrogen molecules, the number 3 is added. One nitrogen molecule gets a 1, and two ammonia molecules get a 2. These coefficient numbers balance the equation, and so this is now called a balanced equation. Note that just as when a subscript is 1, the coefficient 1 is usually not shown. But for the purposes of clarity for this video, we will keep the 1. So now let's look at probably the most neglected, as well as the most important part of the equation, the arrow. What is that arrow telling us? It tells us the reactants are becoming products, that the substances on the left are turning into the substances on the right. In this case, hydrogen and nitrogen are turning into ammonia. How does that happen? It's all hidden in the arrow, so let's take a look underneath. In the case of this reaction, three hydrogen molecules collide with one nitrogen molecule, break apart, and rearrange into two ammonia molecules. So the reactants no longer exist. Their atoms have rearranged into product, which is shown by the equation. That is the chemical reaction, and the reaction is represented by the arrow. The arrow represents that rearrangement of atoms from reactants to products, and that is the chemical reaction, whose participants are represented by the symbols in the chemical equation. We now need to do something very important. We need to adjust our understanding of the coefficients. The way the coefficients have been represented so far, it seems that they are telling us a specific number of substances. Three hydrogen molecules reacting with one nitrogen molecule, producing two ammonia molecules. However, this is a very short-sighted view because in real life, any reaction you can see with your own eyes has many quintillions or sextillions of molecules reacting. That is not an exaggeration, and I hope it gives you an idea of how very, very tiny atoms and molecules are. So a more realistic view of the reaction would be something like this, where many, many molecules are colliding and rearranging, and the few molecules I've added represents the sextillions of molecules actually reacting. However, what you need to see here is that the molecules are reacting in a 3-to-1 ratio of hydrogen and nitrogen, which is the same ratio as the coefficients. There is in total here 9 hydrogens reacting with 3 nitrogens, and that produces 6 ammonia molecules. And so even with quintillions of molecules reacting, they still react in that 3-to-1 ratio given by the coefficients with the same ratio of products. And so rather than giving a specific amount of reactants and products, the coefficients give us the ratio of reactants reacting and the resulting products produced, which in this reaction is a 3-to-1-to-2 ratio. So what other information can a chemical equation give us? First, a quick review. Reactants are on the left side of the arrow. Products are on the right side of the arrow. The arrow represents the atoms rearranging during the reaction. A symbol of the reactants reacting and becoming products. Subscripts tell us how many atoms there are of the element to their left. And coefficients tell how many of each substance balances the equation, as well as the ratio of substances required by the reaction. Let's move on to other important symbols in an equation, using the reaction between Cu and HNO3. From the periodic table, we can see these are the elements copper, hydrogen, nitrogen, and oxygen. So the reaction is between copper metal and a substance called nitric acid. Let's first look at the actual reaction before going further with its equation. Let's use a penny for our source of copper, and the nitric acid is the clear liquid in the flask. You can see when the two reactants come in contact, there is an immediate change that begins to take place. An orange gas bubbles out of the liquid, and the liquid begins to turn green. Let's see what sort of information a chemical equation can provide that can give us insight into what is occurring here. With the entire reaction written out, first you can see the products are CuNO3-2, which is copper nitrate, H2O, or water, and NO2, which is nitrogen dioxide. And I also hope you notice that the equation has been balanced with coefficients. What is important here is to see the states of matter that each substance is in. The S, L, and G tell us these substances are a solid, a liquid, and a gas. So immediately, I hope you can see now that the orange substance bubbling out of the liquid is the nitrogen dioxide, the NO2, which is shown in the equation to be a gas. However, two other very important states are given as well, the AQ, which tells us these substances are aqueous, in other words, that they are dissolved in water. Since we already know that water is a clear liquid, that must mean it is the copper nitrate product dissolved in water that gives the liquid its green color. So the states of matter of products and reactants are excellent guides for what is occurring in the reaction. Finally, as we have seen before, the reactants no longer exist in their reactant form once they have reacted. We can see here that the penny has completely disappeared. It has become copper nitrate. Lastly, we cannot forget the lowly plus sign, which I mentioned just to make sure you know it is used to separate the reactants and the products. It is not used as a mathematical symbol. That's it. This has been a Med Scientist production. See ya.